Coming up, if you haven't looked at serverless options in a while, stay tuned as we look at new enterprise capabilities that help you to apply serverless compute securely and confidently to any workload, including how you can turn on managed service identities and protect secrets with Key Vault integration, control virtual network connectivity for both functions and logic apps, build apps that integrate with the systems inside your virtual networks using serverless capabilities, and set cost thresholds to control how much you want to scale with the Azure Functions Premium plan. So I'm joined by Jeff Hollan from the engineering team leading the efforts around serverless compute at Microsoft. Welcome back to the show.
It's great to be back.
So there's been a lot of progress in serverless compute since we last had you on the show. And to recap, serverless is all about letting you build and run applications at scale without having to deal with managing infrastructure.
Yeah, that's right. There's been a ton of progress that Microsoft's been making in the serverless space because it's a great tool to use for automation of resources, largely because with serverless compute, you're only paying when your compute resources are being used, which makes it a very attractive option to many teams. And we're seeing serverless used in all sorts of scenarios, from web applications to microservices to real-time data processing or even IoT devices. In fact, just a few months ago at Ignite, we showed an end-to-end IoT solution at Microsoft Mechanics Live that was powered entirely by serverless compute and the Azure Sphere.
Yeah, we showed how you could automate the light switch on a locked-down Azure Sphere controlled device. And if you missed that show, you can check it out at the link shown. So it's awesome to see the momentum. I know many people have been wondering just how much they can use serverless in more enterprise type scenarios.
Yeah, we're now at a stage where you can use Azure serverless to run any workload. We've really been focused the last few months on removing common blockers for security, access management, and integration across your internal services and apps. We also now give you a way to set thresholds so that you can scale and control with predictable pricing.
Great, can we take a look?
Yeah, absolutely. So we have here a payment processing app. And as payment requests come in to process a payment, the app's going to need to securely communicate with databases and services. Now, given that we're grabbing customer information, all of this needs to happen inside the firewall. To date, we've held off making the payment processing logic serverless because of the security and compliance requirements. So we've kept this payment processing system on premises.
So how can you move some of this highly secure and mission-critical business logic into serverless without having to compromise on security?
Yeah, so we're going to do a few things here. The first thing we want to do is take that payment processing logic, move it up to the cloud as an Azure function, which is really the core piece of serverless compute. So to do that, the function is going to need to manage identities and leverage secrets in a secure way with Azure Key Vault. We're going to communicate and integrate with our payment processing line of business systems inside our firewall with Azure VNet and Logic Apps. And of course, once the payment has been processed, we'll use an Azure function to trigger the emailing of a payment confirmation back out to the customer.
And these are new capabilities now integrated with Azure Functions.
Yeah, they are. So let me show you how they work. So here I am in my Azure function, and this is the code that's going to be used to process the payment. Now here in my code, you'll notice I'm going to need an account key. This is the key that I use to authenticate with my bank account, obviously the type of secret and information I need to keep secured. So I'm using Azure Key Vault here to manage this secret for me. So I've added the account key, and now Key Vault is encrypting and securing this secret. In fact, if I come here to the access policies, the only piece that has permission to retrieve and read this secret is actually my Azure Function application. Now that's because Azure Functions now uses what's called managed identities for Azure resources, where Azure Active Directory has given my application an identity, which I can use to authenticate with services like Key Vault. So I've gone ahead in my application configuration, and I've set to retrieve my account key from Microsoft Key Vault. All of this happens securely for me. There's no usernames and passwords that I need to manage, so I can be confident in knowing that this secret, this account key, could never be linked to a developer or anyone externally.
Okay, so Key Vault's now storing and encrypting the secrets, and with Azure Functions integrating with managed identities, it securely retrieves the secrets for the payment processing code.
Yeah, that's right. And because we built this integration right into the service, you don't have to make a single line of code in order to start leveraging Key Vault to receive any secrets that your serverless app might need.
Awesome. So how easy is it to integrate with systems that are behind the firewall? I know that's been a big pain point in the past.
Yeah, as we showed you earlier in the illustration, this payment processor code is going to need to communicate with systems that are within a VNet, some that are in cloud, some that might be on premises. Now, in the past, Azure Functions hasn't provided a way to integrate directly with a VNet, but today you can very quickly add an Azure function to a VNet so it can securely communicate directly to the resources within that VNet. So I'm back here at our payment processing code, and after we have the account key, I need to make a call here to this private IP address. You see this is a 10.0 address within my VNet. Now, if I tried to call it right now and run this code, you'll actually notice that this run is failing. I don't have access to the VNet. I need some way to gain that access to securely communicate. So I'm going to come into my function app settings, and here in networking, I can just simply choose to configure a VNet connection. So I'm going to come here, add my VNet. Here it's listing the different VNets that my application has access to. I can choose the VNet that I want, choose the subnet, and click OK. Just like that, my Azure function is now securely being connected to my VNet. So if I come back over to the application code again and press run, now that I've made that change, my application's succeeding. This call to the internal system is traveling through that VNet, never over the public internet, and my code is now working. I'm confident in knowing that my traffic is completely locked down and secure.
And with most enterprise systems having very tight network isolation, integrating with VNets is a huge win. I know, though, that one downside can be the cold start time penalty for brokering connections to resources as code's initiated. How do we solve for that?
Yeah, we really don't want people to have to sacrifice on performance when they're adding these types of security features. So when you use this new VNet functionality, we're actually going to keep your app warm and connected to the VNet so you're not going to hit any additional latency.
Right, so we've covered secrets management and network security, but what are we doing to solve for secure communication between services?
Yeah, our team's been hard at work over the last few months to give you the ability to even run your logic apps in an integration service environment. Now, this means that I can build a workflow inside of my VNet as well. So as our function is processing code, it's actually going to kick off an event that's going to trigger this logic app workflow. I'm going to retrieve some customer information through my on-premises SQL database. It's going to call to generate a receipt, and then finally update some information in CRM, which is also on premises. Now, because this logic app is built inside of the integration service environment, even these calls to on-premises systems are succeeding and everything is working in a secured way.
Awesome stuff. It's really powerful to see that you now integrate with services behind your firewall, but what if my operation sees a spike in demand and I want to control how it scales so that I don't have a huge bill at the end of the month?
One of the most difficult conversations we sometimes have with these large enterprises is, you know, how much is this application going to cost me? Because if the function only runs once, it might be free, but if it runs 100 billion times, it's going to be a lot more money. So one of the features that we now offer to enterprises is predictable pricing. You can control the bounds in which your function app runs to keep your bill within a secured range. For some companies, you might want pay as you grow. But for others, you may want to ring fence a set of resources across your apps and have a fixed, predictable cost every month. In fact, for some very high volume workloads, you can actually save money by paying by the resource instead of by the execution, and only Azure gives you this option for both in its serverless offerings. So here in the Azure portal, this is where I can control the bounds in which my app is going to scale. I can choose to have some instances always warmed so I don't have any latency, and I can choose the minimum and maximum limits so that I get flexible options in deciding just what resources will be available and how much I'm going to pay every month. Now, these elements of security, performance, and predictability enable every company to take advantage of serverless for key mission-critical scenarios.
Awesome. Now, with all these changes, we're looking forward to seeing the shift from managing sporadic workloads with serverless to running everyday systems.
Absolutely. And we're seeing a lot of interest across industries. For example, in finance, there's a lot of companies interested in analyzing and processing transactions and trends. We've been working with retail companies who are leveraging functions within their VNets to process real-time data at massive scale. It's really exciting to see the power and productivity serverless can unlock for every scenario.
What's the best way to get started with these new capabilities?
So we just released the preview of the new Azure Functions Premium plan. You just need to follow a few steps to get your first premium app running and connected to a secure environment. If you want to use the integration service environment for your logic apps and workflows, you can sign up for the preview as well. And don't forget to check out our Microsoft Learn modules on serverless, where you can learn about applicable scenarios and even play around with some code samples.
And of course, subscribe and keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for our latest tech updates. Bye for now.